Alright everyone, welcome to the TF2 video commentary, and I am playing as a spy on Gorge today. And you might notice that I've been playing, lots of my videos always end up being on Gorge or Badwater. It's because it's one of my most favourite maps, and I play a lot. Although, recently, having started making these videos, I have actually tried to play other maps a lot more, and that's actually working out well. It's kind of improving myself, so I don't just noob it up on just the same map with the same strategy and same routines. So yeah, I tried to mix it up a little. But we are in Gorge here now, and I'm using normal InvisiWatch because I noticed I was using a lot of Dead Ringer and yeah, a bit of sidestep. That kind of satisfied to get. And yeah, I've forgotten how useful it is to just go invisible at will. I jumped down here, I thought they were all going to just charge forward, but that soldier is a bit aware. And here, I've got no disguise. That's one trouble with using your eternal ward, you can't disguise. But if you see opportunities like that sentry gun was useless basically, well, for anyone on the right hand side of it, because that dispenser was giving me cover, and yeah, I could have got that engineer backstab for a disguise, but it kind of didn't work out. That soldier fired a charge shot at me, and then I get team balanced. Happens all the time to me. It's like, I don't know, it feels like it happens all the time to me, because I suppose you don't notice when other people get balanced. It's not really a big announcement. You get a big huge like sign across the top, but for most other people it's just a little text notification, and you probably miss it. Probably other people get balanced as much as I do, it's just, but whatever. And here, I am disguised as a heavy. Obviously, I don't really need to be cloaked in like friendly area, but I'm cloaking just to speed myself up. When you're cloaked, you obviously regain your normal movement speed. I'm disguised as the heavy, and then, well, I've gotten rid of the disguise now because I didn't want to. I didn't want the slow speed, it's kind of a hindrance. And if you're confident that you can get another disguise easily, then you might as well. So, like, there's a heavy target. I see a spy, and I kind of abort, kind of think, oops, that's not good. And there, that's a spy. I think, hey, I can get my disguise here. And I see the twitching of my knife. Ah, finally! And that's another great thing, obviously, spy checking with just your knife. Your knife will raise into a kind of backstabbing position if NG kind of exposes the back. If you're behind a disguised enemy spy, your knife will raise into a backstabbing position, so you can easily tell if you can spy check people by just standing behind them. And that's always good. And here, unfortunately, we're getting taken out. All our defenses are getting destroyed. But we do actually manage to survive. There's a spy, obvious, just bumps right into our NG. I get disguised here. And there's another thing that I do is I always cheer, like I've said this like a million times in my other videos, I always cheer and battle cry whenever I get someone. It's, it gives me away. I thought that heavy wasn't going to turn around, I wanted to give up my disguise, but then there's a sentry up there as well. And here I get to the right stupid position. I thought, I'm gonna die there if I stay there. I've got not a cloak. Whatever. That was a bit of a screw up. But yeah, InvisiWatch, I actually like it. It lets you get out of situations pretty easily. I mean, the Dead Ringer is also good for escaping, but the InvisiWatch kind of lets you get into places more stealthily. Although with the Dead Ringer, you can obviously disguise as a friendly. As a friendly team member, and you, when you get killed by the enemy, they think they just killed like whatever you disguise as, like a friendly pyro, and they'll just think, oh, I just killed their pyro. They don't just suspect that you're a spy at all. So that's a good use of the Dead Ringer to get into your territory unnoticed, rather than disguising as the enemy, then getting killed. And it's kind of like obvious then to them that there's a Dead Ringer spy around. But with the InvisiWatch, there's none of that. It's just walk right in. On-demand invisibility is always fun. And I've been playing a lot with the InvisiWatch, and I actually prefer this now to the Dead Ringer. Although with the Your Eternal Reward, it makes it a little harder, but it makes it also fun for me. I like using the Eternal Reward. It's It's one of the most satisfying weapons to get killed with, although it's probably also similarly the most annoying weapon to get killed by. Your body just slumps down, and you don't scream, you just disappear, and then you see yourself in the kill cam. But yeah, that's that. So yeah, I think I will be making a vanilla loadout. Just a normal knife, normal Invisi Watch. I think that is one of the most fun and best loadouts there is. It's just a vanilla spy. Although there is a spicicle now, although sometimes I actually don't like how the spicicle melts. It's kind of annoying, and I thought he was going to expose his back for longer. I thought I actually got him there, but nope. Yeah. I saw my spy, my fellow team's member spy, taking him on. I thought I could maybe help him out with a gun, with the ambassador. Obviously, I'm using the ambassador. Normal rover, or vanilla loadout. I think I still prefer the ambassador though. I love the headshots. Sneaking up on people and just blasting them. So much fun. And sometimes you can get some lucky shots off, like there, when there's people on the balcony there. I know I've sniped a few people there. And here, I think I need to get a disguise to get an, oh dear. Oh dear. I'm just making a scare. I didn't even try to get a lucky backstab or anything like that. In this gameplay, I think I've made I keep running up there in circles. I keep this like routine going. I go up there, try and get someone, try and sap something, and then I just get out alive. I don't take any more risks. And it's kind of handy that that medic is actually really aware and gave me quite a bit of trouble. So that this is actually good. He's a good medic, like medics should be. They should be aware. They shouldn't just stand around. I couldn't get a swipe on it. Thought I was going to get my disguise there. But that teleport is actually pretty a good thing for me, and I decide to go after the spy. I know he's around here somewhere. There he is. I just saw him flicker. Yeah. Luckily, get him before the sentry. Well, I think he was disguised, obviously, but that teleporter up there is really handy for me. It's a bit of a weird position. It even ports them facing the wall. That's always a bad thing. Engineers, when they should always consider spies camping teleporters. They should always rotate. And I run right into pirate. They should always rotate the teleporters so you come out the teleporters with your back to the wall rather than facing the wall. I think some engineers realize that they can rotate with mouse 2 the porters and stuff, because that is, I could just stand there backstabbing anyone. Even if they know that there's a spy waiting, they don't have time to react. You just instantly stab them. Yeah, I want to jump down and he thinks I'm down there. That's good for me. Doesn't work out quite that so well, but I still managed to backstab him. And here, I tried to ignore that guy's shot so he thinks that I'm just like a genuine team member. And you should try, well, you can try that if you know you're going to survive. Just stay unfazed, don't cloak, don't start firing back. Just ignore this the enemy shooting at you. Because they might end up just stop, they might think, oh, he's not a spy then, and they just stop shooting. It's worked for me quite a few times. You just gotta know what the limits are, I guess. And here, I finally managed to take him out. Finally, the medic lets his guard down, and that works out nicely for me. I get a bit of an overheal, and I just clean this place up. Hey, that worked out fine for me, finally. After many routes, many attempts of going around there, many aborted, many escapes, I managed to actually take you out. Except for the teleporter, this spy is just like AFK or something, I don't know. And oh, again, bit of a face stab, but I think that was a side stab again. Like I said, the area of backstabbing people is actually pretty wide. You can stand in front of them, and it's not really lag, it's just the way the game is. It's like, I don't know, something like 200 degrees around you, something like that. It's kind of like a huge area where you can actually backstab people from. But that's why you always end up seeing, always get face stabbed by overly aggressive spies. That medic spy checking again, and they finally got pyro. That's not good for me. That heavy O is kind of unaware. That sapper's gonna get undone. I'm gonna be spending the entire game basically trying to get that area done. I mean, I thought I'd cleared it out the first time. I got a huge kind of destruction spree and killing spree there. And no, the teleport survived, and the teleport is probably like the most important thing there. It allows them to stream in, and I continue my quest to get rid of that. And there's more pyros. I'm like, oh no, this is not good. Try to get a few headshots. That pyro is just standing there, and I'm lucky that they're actually not checking the ammo crates and stuff. I mean, I always look out to see if ammo crates are missing and stuff, or they just disappear on their own, because then you know there's a spy there. I've spotted quite a few spies using that method. Just have a look and see if the ammo is still there, then otherwise you know that someone's recently picked it up, and if there's no teammates around, you might as well be more cautious. Yeah, I finally do it again. I don't know if I can actually... Nah, I bought... There's a pyro there. That's one thing. You should be more cautious. You shouldn't just try get everything done instantly. You know, get out there if you can. And, oh dear. I get him down with... While he's got a Uber charge. This part here. There's a pyro. we are having trouble getting this done because there's an engineer and a pyro repairing and unsapping that, and we finally managed to get it down. There's scouts here. This is like a huge battle, and like get that port destroyed. Ah, why is it not dying? This is so annoying. And then finally, yes, and I just decided to talk because I was just in tears there. It was just hilarious. Like, just this battle for the teleport, it finally goes down. Yeah. Oh, I need to get backstabbed. Luckily, that spy misses, and I'm like, my screen's shaking. I'm just laughing. I thought, is that a spy? He's kind of suspicious there, all in the corner. And that's one thing. I don't know. Hello? Oh, and I get headshot. he shouts for a spy, and then he receives the bullet. I tried to backstab him and jump stab, but. I've only done a few stair stabs in my spy career. It's kind of a rare occurrence for me. And yeah, it's like, I think this is pretty much it. 35 seconds on the clock. That's that. And yeah, people hiding in corners, like that soldier. Kind of like, you should not act so suspiciously. I don't, like that corner there, for some reason, people always go there, spies always go there. Well, more inexperienced spies, I don't know why. Just, like, fire a few shots there and you'll probably get killed. That's what I've found as a soldier. Not a good space. Not a good spot. I thought I was gonna die there. Nope. And that's that. Top score, like, quite a bit. But I think you get just ridiculous amount of points for just getting a backstab, even though there's an instant kill. Actually, I don't know how scoring works, but that's that. So, thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.